Hi, good day. This is Miss LM and we're back again for another math videos and still we are on operations with rational algebraic expressions and we're going to talk about addition and subtraction of similar RAEs. So before we proceed in identifying the steps in adding and subtracting similar rational algebraic expressions, let us know first what are similar rational algebraic expressions. So similar RAEs are those RAEs with the same denominator. So as you can see in the symbol here, all of the denominators are the same from the given up to the sum and difference. So now what are the steps in adding and subtracting similar rational algebraic expressions? So for step number one, we have to add or subtract the numerators and keep the denominator the same. Step number two, combine like terms in the numerator. Remember the word like terms. When we say like terms, these are the terms with the same variables with exactly the same exponent, okay? And then on step number three, we have to simplify the final answer by looking for the common factors among the numerator and the denominator. So do not forget, we're still going to use factoring to arrive at the simplified form of our final answer. Okay, so now let's have example number one. We have here 5 over 6j to the fourth power plus 7 all over 6j to the fourth power. So as you can see, the denominators are the same. So what we're going to do is to follow the steps. Step number one is to add or subtract the numerators. So since we have here addition symbol, that means we're going to add the numerators. What are the numerators? We have 5 and 7. Then keep the denominator the same. 6j to the fourth power. Step number two, combine like terms. Are they like terms? Yes, because they are both constants. So 5 plus 7 is 12 all over 6j to the fourth. Now, to have our final answer, is there a common factor among the numerator and the denominator? We have 12 and 6. 12 and 6 are both divisible by 6, so we can cancel this out. The result will be 12 divided by 6 is 2, 6 divided by 6 is 1. Now we can write our final answer. What will be the numerator? That is 2. And then for the denominator, we have 1 times j to the 4th. The answer is j to the 4th power. So the final answer for example number 1 is 2 all over j to the 4th power. Now, let's have example number 2. We have here negative 3a all over 8b squared c minus negative 5a all over 8b squared c. So, same denominator. What we're going to do is to add or subtract the numerator. What are the numerators? We have negative 3a minus negative 5a all over the common denominator, which is 8b squared c. Okay, so in subtracting integers, there is a rule KCC on your grade 7 lesson. If you could still remember that, that means keep change change. So what we're going to do on the first term, keep 3a as negative 3a and then change the operation from minus to plus and then the sign of the second term from negative to positive. So we have positive 5a na all over our similar denominator, which is 8b squared c. Now we have to combine our numerators. Are they the same? Are they like terms? So yes, because they have both variable a with exactly the same exponent. So 5a plus negative 3a or negative 3a plus 5a, the answer is 2a all over 8b squared c. Now, for our final step, we have to simplify our answer. Is there a common factor among the numerator and denominator? So, as you can see, we have 2 and 8. They are both divisible by 2. 2 divided by 2 is 2. 8 divided by 2 is 4. Then, we have to write our final answer. 1 times a is a all over 4 times b squared c is 4b squared c. Now, this will be the answer for example number 2. Okay, let's have example number 3. We have here 4 over k minus 3 plus 1 over 3 minus k. So if we have this kind of denominator, we have to take note of this. When one denominator is the opposite or the additive inverse of the other, multiply one expression by negative 1 over negative 1. This gives a common denominator. So ang gagawin daw natin is to multiply negative 1 over negative 1 to one of our RAEs. But before that, let us rewrite first our RAEs. We have 4 all over k minus 3 plus 1 all over. So let's reposition these terms. We have negative k plus 3. Then multiply negative 1 over negative 1 to this second RAE. So rewrite the first RAE again. We have 4 all over k minus 3 plus 1 times negative 1. Again, 1 times negative 1 is negative 1 all over. Again, this is a binomial multiplied by negative 1. Negative k times negative 1, we have positive k. Positive 3 times negative 1, we have negative 3. So as you can see, they have now same denominator. Now we can add or combine our numerators. 4 plus negative 1, that is positive 3 all over k minus 3. So this will be our final answer for example number 3. Again, we cannot cancel this term and this term because they are not common factor. They are terms. Again, they are not common factor. They are terms. So that's why we cannot cancel it. Now let's have example number 4. We have here 7m minus 15 all over m squared minus 36 minus 2m plus 15 all over m squared minus 36. So for step number 1, again, we have to subtract our numerators. We have here 7m minus 15 minus the quantity of 2m plus 15. So as you can see, I enclosed the second numerator into a quantity because, again, we have subtraction as operation and it will affect the sign of our second numerators. So next, we're going to put our common denominator, which is m squared minus 36. Now, since we are having a subtraction here, and remember, we have the rule KCC, keep the minuend, and then change the sign of the subtrahend, and then the operation will be addition. So, let's apply that here. We have here 7m minus 15, then this will be our subtrahend from positive, that will be negative 2m. From positive 15, we have negative 15 all over our common denominator, which is m squared minus 36. Now, let's combine the like terms. We have 7m and negative 2m. So, different sign. That means we are going to subtract the absolute values. 7 minus 2 is 5m. And then we have negative 15 and negative 15, similar sign. So, we're going to combine the absolute values, or we're going to add the absolute values. And that is 30 all over our common denominator m squared minus 36. Now from this 5m minus 30 all over m squared minus 36, we're going to factor it and we have to simplify this. So 5m and negative 30, there is a common factor which is positive 5. So, factor that out. 5m divided by 5, we have m. 30 divided by 5, we have 6 all over our denominator, which is a binomial with square roots, and the operation is subtraction. So, difference of two squares. The factors are the square root of the first term, square root of the second term, and then 1 plus or 1 positive, 1 negative. Now, we can cancel out the common factor, which is m minus 6, that will become 1, and then multiply the remaining factors. 5 times 1 is 5. Quantity of m plus 6 times 1 is m plus 6. So this will be the final answer for our example number 4. Okay, let's have our final example. We have here 8x squared plus 11x all over 2x squared plus 13x plus 20 minus 4x squared minus 5x all over 2x squared plus 13x plus 20. So for step number 1, we have to add or subtract our numerator. So 8x squared plus 11x minus the quantity of 4x squared minus 5x. Remember to put the subtrahend into quantity because the sign will be changed later on because our operation is subtraction. Then copy our common denominator to 2x squared plus 13x plus 20. Now, we have to change the sign of our subtrahend. 4x squared positive, that will become negative. Negative 5x, that will become positive 5x. Again, all over our common denominator, which is 2x squared plus 13x plus 20. Now, combine like terms, we have 8x squared and negative 4x squared, that is positive 4x squared. 11x and 5x, that is 16x. All over again 2x squared plus 13x plus 20. Now let's factor the numerator and the denominator. For the numerator, we have 4x squared plus 16x. Common factors are 4x. Then factor that out. 4x squared divided by 4x is x. 16x divided by 4x is 4. All over, what will be the factors of 2x squared plus 13x plus 20? We have 2x plus 5 times x plus 4. Now, we can cancel out or divide out common factor, and that is x plus 4. We have 1 there. Now, multiply the remaining factors. 4x times 1 is 4x. 2x plus 5 times 1 is 2x plus 5. This will be the final answer. We cannot cancel out 4x and 2x because they are now terms. So, this is the final answer for the final example. That ends our video lesson for today. I hope you learned something from this video. Give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe, like, and share this video. Thank you for watching. Bye!